One thing that's always been a fascination of mine are individuals who you would maybe refer to as batshit crazy. You know, people who are, how you say, utterly deranged. So, without further ado, my name is Rayquinator, and I return from the great beyond to bring you my absolutely comprehensive list of my favorite deranged individuals. John McAfee is the founder of McAfee Antivirus, which is probably installed on your grandfather's computer right now. After selling the company, he proceeded to make a video called How to Uninstall McAfee Antivirus, which features cocaine and copious amounts of hookers. What's crazy is that this is probably the least deranged thing he did. He's been arrested numerous times for both manufacturing drugs and taking drugs, as well as firearm charges, and was also facing a wrongful death lawsuit for a man who was found shot in the head on his property in Belize. While the police were investigating this death, they found him reportedly buried in the sand with a cardboard box over his head. After this, he proceeded to try to run for president in both 2016 and 2020 under the Libertarian Party. You know, the party famous for booing a man out of a debate for suggesting that maybe people should have driver's licenses before we let them out on the open road.
Should someone have to have a government-issued license to drive a car?
Hell no!
What's next, requiring a license to make toast in your own damn toaster?
The license to drive? You know, I'd like to see some competency exhibited by people before they drive.
In 2019, he announced that he was living on a boat to avoid getting arrested for tax evasion charges. And in 2020, he was formally arrested for these charges in Spain and proceeded to commit suicide before he could be extradited back to Tennessee. Now here's the thing. About a year before he did this, he tweeted out, "Know that if I hang myself, it was no fault of mine." Which means either one, he was murdered, boring, or he did the funniest thing of all time. Because I don't know about you, but the most entertaining thing you could conceivably do is tell everyone, "I will never kill myself. If you find out that I killed myself, it wasn't me. Look into it." And then proceeding to turn around and kill yourself, just leaving everyone behind to fucking ponder what happened, is the best prank you could possibly pull on the world. Emperor Caligula was an ancient Roman emperor who was pretty well known for just generally being off his rocker, like, you know, just straight up devoid of rationality. But what takes the cake is one time he declared war on Poseidon, the god of the sea, and the only way he could conceive of to wage war against what's essentially a personification of the ocean was to have his soldiers repeatedly stab the sea. He also had them collect seashells and, like, you know, sea glass or whatever, and called them the spoils of the ocean. As a result of this, the Atlantis Stock Exchange went down by a record 50 points, and the Romans lost 150,000 legionaries during the battle. Alright, I'll be real, I made those last two parts up, but you get the idea. Guy was batshit. I've already spoken about Mr. Howard in my cult classic video, Terryology, but if you aren't initiated, Terrence Howard is a B-list actor who has his own personal math ideology, which the founding principle of it is that 1 equals 2. He treats this like it's some hidden esoteric knowledge, and I'll be honest, I don't know enough about math to definitively disprove what he says. But if I were a betting man, and my options were the entire mathematical community, and Brody from Iron Man 1, I'm probably going with the scientists. Also, side note, on my video about Terryology, which I released, you know, 2 years back at this point, half the comments were just supportive, like, "nice video, man," which I really appreciate. But the other half were from what appears to be a clique of Terrence Howard stans, who were just shitting on me for maybe implying that the entire foundation of modern math is not incorrect. Anyways, you get the deal. Guy's got a screw loose. Kenneth Copeland is a wildly successful televangelist who you might have seen just a few years back explaining why his pastoral duties absolutely require a private jet and a personal airport. His argument being, and I quote, "God can't hear me if I try to talk to him while I'm flying coach." But my chief evidence for his insanity is the entire catalog of creepy-ass faces he makes while insisting that he is God's chosen prophet. I could go into more detail, but I'll be honest, most of what he says is what you'd expect from a megachurch pastor who looks like he's from the Neolithic era. Terry Davis was a schizophrenic yet talented computer programmer who claimed that during what he called a vision from God, but was probably a psychological break, God told him to construct a new second temple in the form of a computer operating system. And I shit you not, this man single-handedly coded a completely unique operating system from the ground up, which is not a one-man job. In fact, other programmers would compare this to building a skyscraper by yourself. He called the operating system Temple OS, and he claimed it would allow him to talk to God and regularly used it for this purpose. In fact, he taught it how to play chess and then proceeded to beat it, which then gave him the exclusive bragging rights to say, "I beat God at chess," which, schizophrenia aside, is pretty badass. Sadly, his mental health only continued to worsen, and he was struck by a train at the age of 48. Andrew Jackson was our 7th president, and aside from committing a genocide or two, as we all do, he was generally crazy. He nearly beat a would-be assassin to death with a cane, partook in duels, and kept a 1,400-pound block of cheese in the White House lobby. I would go into more detail, but covering a president seems a little superfluous. Timothy Treadwell was a man who was convinced that he had some sort of spiritual connection to bears. He would routinely travel to Alaska during the summer to live near the bears and generally seemed to lack basic self-preservation instinct. As you might expect, he and his girlfriend ended up getting mauled to death in the early 2000s. If you want more information on him, I highly recommend watching The Grizzly Man, which is a fantastic documentary. Emperor Nero of Rome was another Roman emperor who supposedly burned down 2/3 of Rome just so he could build like a new palace, which, in my opinion, nets him the title of the coolest arsonist of all time. Like, he was the emperor. Like, couldn't he have just, like, asked for some land to build his new palace? Like, I doubt burning down 2/3 of Rome was the move. Rasputin, you should know who this is if you've taken, like, a high school history class at all in your life. But he was, you know, he was a Russian wizard who just kind of refused to die. He's really well known, but I figured I'd throw him in because he was just completely fucking insane. General MacArthur is another one of those people that you should probably know about if you've taken a high school history class, but if you're not aware, he was one of the top generals of the World War II period and into the 50s, and during the Korean War, he went up to Truman and was like, "Hey man, with only a couple nukes, we could just obliterate the Korea-China border." Of course, Truman turned around and was like, are you fucking neurotic? Do you just not have any consideration for the well-being of your fellow man?" And of course, MacArthur was just kind of like, "Yeah." John Allen Chow was a man who, in 2018, decided to go to North Sentinel Island to try to convert the natives to Christianity. If you don't know what North Sentinel Island is, it's one of the last truly uncontacted peoples on Earth. Like, we're not even sure if they've figured out fire yet. Like, we don't think they have writing. We don't really know what their language is like. So, John Allen Chow heard all this and thought, "Surely these people that don't understand language will be very receptive to the teachings of the Lord." As you might predict, he ended up getting fucking mag-dumped with arrows. Also, side note, the way researchers think that the natives originally got to that island is that one day, a few natives from a neighboring island were like, "Hey man, let's go on a little canoe trip, you know, 20-minute adventure," and they canoed over to the island. And then their canoe, like, blew away, and they were like, "Fuck, man, we didn't bring the guy who knows how to build canoes with us." So their entire bloodline just got relegated to, you know, still being in the Stone Age for all of eternity. Anyways, that's it. I probably forgot a few people, and, you know, maybe I'll make a part 2 or something at some point. But that's it for today. If you enjoyed the video, you can either leave a like in the comment or mail a pipe bomb to my address. Either way, the same message gets sent across.